Now, we come into verse 32, and I'm just hitting high points now. And upon whatsoever any of them, when they are dead, doth fall, it shall be unclean. Now, when a little varmint, for instance, falls into a pot or pan in the kitchen, what happens? Well, if it's an earthen vessel, they were to break the pot and throw it away. If it was bronze, they were to scour it good. You see that what we've done now, we've left the dining room and we enter the kitchen where the meal is prepared. And an unclean creature could fall into an earthen jar and just ruin the meal, you see. And God taught his people cleanliness and the preparation of food. That is something it took man a long time to learn apart from the Word of God. We are told also, if an unclean animal should fall, now notice this at verse 36, nevertheless a fountain or pit wherein there's plenty of water shall be clean, but that which toucheth their carcass shall be unclean. Now if a carcass falls into a great big lake, it won't make the lake unclean. No. And isn't that interesting? The Lord Jesus Christ is that fountain or lake, friends. He could touch a leper and heal him. He didn't get the leprosy. What a picture you have here of him. Now, we are told that seed that is to be sown, if a carcass touch it, it won't hurt it. The seed has a shell on it. But suppose it's been soaked in water, the seed has, and that shell is gone. Then the seed's unclean and should be thrown away. Now, the child of God today needs an armor in this world. Put on the whole armor of God, we're told. And if you and I are going out to rub against a lost world, we'll need the armor of God. Now, we have the contamination of creeping creatures way down at the end of this chapter. And every creeping thing that creepeth on the earth shall be an abomination, it shall not be eaten. All creeping things were unclean, as they were representative of the fall of man. It was the curse pronounced upon the serpent, on your belly you shall go. God says, let these creeping things alone. What a lesson that we have here. Then will you notice this chapter concludes, this remarkable chapter. This is the law of the beasts and of the fowl and of every living creature that moveth in the waters and of every creature that creepeth upon the earth to make a difference between the unclean and the clean, between the beasts that may be eaten and the beasts that may not be eaten. It's God who makes the sharp distinction between the clean and the unclean. And holiness in little things is therefore essential. And it becomes, I think, the real test for God's man. You see, the acid tests of any life, of any of God's people. God says, I am your Lord. I'm holy. Be ye holy. And we are distinguished by the world today. And my friend, you have to make a decision whether you're going to walk with God and for God in the world today. What a lesson is in this chapter of clean and unclean animals. And by the way, the next chapter is just as remarkable as this one.